What's good, YouTubers and YouTubettes? This is JB Sports, back again with another one. I gotta eat a little crow. I gotta eat a lot of crow because I predicted that Demetrius Boo Boo Andrade would beat David Benavidez by decision. And David Benavidez ended up stopping Demetrius Boo Boo Andrade in the first half of that fight. Didn't get past the sixth round. I thought the first two rounds, I had it 1-1, but even watching the first two rounds, when Boo Boo Andrade was able to do some good things in the ring, he was able to keep the fight for the most part in the middle of the ring. He was boxing, he was turning David Benavidez, but David Benavidez was very competitive when Boo Boo Andrade was having his best work. He was very, very competitive in that style of fight with Boo Boo Andrade, which was a fight that was in the center of the ring. Both guys were landing good shots. And that kind of surprised me that David Benavidez was competitive in a boxing match with Demetrius Boo Boo. When it was a boxing match, and both guys was landing shots and they was, you know, setting shots up and, you know, throwing combinations and doing what they do, David Benavidez was very, very competitive in the first couple of rounds when Boo Boo Andrade was doing his best work. So that gave me cause for concern when I saw that going down in the first two rounds. And after the second round, it was all David Benavidez. He was able to turn up the heat. And it's an old saying, if you can't stand the heat, get the hell out the kitchen. And that's exactly what Boo Boo Andrade did. He got the hell out that kitchen in the sixth round. He got dropped. He never fully recovered from the knockdown. And he got punished. And it was a good thing that his cone stopped that fight when it did, because it was going to only get worse from there on. And David Benavidez proved that he is one of the best fighters in boxing. This was a signature win for David Benavidez. David Benavidez showed that he can not only come forward and bring the pressure, but he can, if you want to fight, you want to box, you want to be a technical type of fight, he can be competitive in that type of fight too. He showed his boxing skills in this fight. He showed the whole arsenal in this fight. Not only he's a great come forward pressure fighter, but he's a guy that can box too. So I kind of saw that early on in his career, but I hadn't seen that lately, so I kind of forgot that he could box. You know, when he fought Gabriel, when he fought him, man, he boxed him, especially in the rematch. He outboxed him. He gave him a boxing lesson that second fight. You go back and watch that fight. But ever since then, he's been more of a fan-friendly, come-forward type of fighter. So I kind of forgot about that version of David Benavidez. But he showed in the first two rounds of the Boo Boo Andrade fight that he can not only bring the pressure, but he can also box. So great win for David Benavidez. Everybody want to see him take on Canelo Alvarez next. Canelo Alvarez, from what I'm hearing, is in negotiations to take on Jaime Munguia. And if he fights Munguia instead of Benavidez, that's a damn shame. That's truly, truly will be an embarrassment for Canelo Alvarez. But it won't be an embarrassment for his pocket, because he's going to make big-time money no matter who he fights. He's in that type of position where it don't really matter who he's going to fight. He's going to get his $50 million guaranteed no matter if he fight Munguia, Benavidez, Jamal Charlo, or whoever. He's going to get his $50 million, man, because he is the cash cow of boxing. He's one of the faces of boxing along with Tank Davis, and he is the big ball and shot caller in that regard. So we will see what happens, and we will see what transpires. Now, Boo Boo Andrade, this was his biggest fight of his career. He gave it all, man, but at the end of the day, man, he did not have enough power. That I did say in my prediction video, I thought he was going to have enough pop on his punches to get Benavidez respect, but obviously that wasn't the case. He hit Benavidez with a good shot in that second round, and he had Benavidez on the ropes as he was hitting him with some vicious body punches. But after that went down, David Benavidez took over the fight. So David Benavidez might have got stunned at that moment, but he was able to quickly recover, and then he really turned up the pressure. Beautiful body work by David Benavidez. He's hitting him with the uppercut. And like I said in the prediction video, man, he has an underrated jab, man. That jab is what he does to close distance. People think he's just some come-forward fighter, bringing pressure, swinging big shots and stuff like that. That's not the case, man. He's coming in behind an educated jab, kind of like Errol Spence Jr. does. Errol Spence Jr. is a pressure fighter, too, but he comes in behind the jab. He closed distance behind the jab, and that's exactly what David Benavidez does. And that's a very positive attribute for David Benavidez. So we will see what happens, and we will see what transpires. But I asked some people come in the comment section, say, nah, man, David Benavidez is going to walk through Boo Boo Andrade. He's going to punish Boo Boo Andrade. I got to give you guys y'all flowers, man. Y'all were right, man. At the end of the day, David Benavidez was too big for Boo Boo Andrade. I told you in the prediction video, David Benavidez could be fighting that cruiserweight, really. And I heard Jim Lampley, who used to work for HBO, he was saying that David Benavidez got a good chance down the line to become a big attraction in the heavyweight division, becoming the first truly big Mexican-American heavyweight. Now, we had a Mexican-American heavyweight a few years ago in Andy Ruiz, but it was short-lived as he beat Anthony Joshua, and then he lost the rematch. But Jim Lampley was saying that he has a chance to really go to the heavyweight division and have a lot of success in the heavyweight division and become a big attraction because, you know, the heavyweight division is the glamour division in the sport of boxing. And for you to have a Mexican-American heavyweight champion, that would really be big for the sport, man. He would be a real big name, not only in the sport of boxing, but I think that would probably transcend sports. So we will see what happens. And we will see what transpires. Follow me on Facebook, Gerard Briscoe. Like, share, and subscribe to JB Sports, the man, the myth, the legend. And I holla.